Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and tonight we're going to take a look at the brand new Saurian update. The game officially has playable Triceratopses. Look, I'll click a button, and things happen. Playable Triceratops is in the game now. If you want to play this for yourselves, you will need to access the public beta test branch. Thingamajig is actually a pre-alpha test branch. I'm going to link the website down below on how to do that. It's also a very entertaining image on that website. Everyone should go check out. But it's very easy to do. All you have to do is go into your Steam properties and put in a beta password. All this kind of jazz. Now, it's worth mentioning this is buggy. It really does. It has some bug problems. It isn't, you know, the stable full release quite yet. So there are some issues. You may notice I'm actually not an adult, I'm a sub-adult. Hey guys, let's go say hi to these Edmontosauruses. Although the game calls them Anathosaurus, and I've never been quite sure why. If anyone can clarify that, that'd be great. Because it says it's also known as Edmontosaurus. It's an Anathosaurus / Edmontosaurus annectans, basically. Male, female. Alright, how are we doing? Living large, in charge? I'm sure we are. So, I sat down this morning and recorded Saurian for 3 hours. 3 hours, this whole life cycle from baby to adult. We tested out some new things that the trike has. It's got some pretty cool stuff. We've got a social display. It kind of zooms out and you get this weird little button, as you can see, and you can click on someone. Wait, did I just join this herd? Really? No? What? Well, let me back in. Eh? Eh? I'll be here. Yeah. No. It's pointing me in and then kicking me out straight away. I don't think I'm allowed to join the herd. But there's like this whole new herding mechanic. Now, I can't show where you are right now because I'm not in a herd because I kind of abandoned my herd mates. But I will load in as a baby at the end of this sub-adult-adult bit and I'll show you the herd mechanics because it's actually a pretty cool system. And I think it's the big sort of hook for the Triceratops is this herding system. But we've got social display, we've got threaten. Put the spooks on them, and we also have warning. Now, I don't know why you have this here, this little circular button. I don't know if the idea is to click the dinosaur you're trying to warn, or maybe you see a T-Rex approaching in the distance and you kind of click over there and you're like, as you do, you know, T-Rex on the way. Anyways, my point was, I recorded Saurian for 3 hours, loads of gameplay. I mean, not much happened, admittedly. Most of it was me AFK waiting for my try to grow up. This is 3 hours in, by the way, this level of growth. I'm not even a bloody adult yet, after 3 hours. Anyways, I got to the end of the video and I hit stop recording. I was relieved, you know, ooh, you're a little bit spooked, aren't you, buddy? What's going on? It was finally over after 3 long hours and I kind of shut my recording program down a little bit too quickly before I had time to process this massive video and it crashed and I lost 3 hours of video and like an hour of commentary. So we're gonna keep today short and sweet because I can't do any more. My brain will break. I'm just gonna show you the bloody Triceratops basically. So here she is. This is the female version. The adult, the male has like a slightly more elaborate patterning, brighter colors and stuff like that. If you don't have a male or female preference, which I didn't, I clicked on random, I would recommend playing the male because I do think it looks a little bit more interesting. I definitely show you the baby because it's very interesting, but other than that, there isn't too much to say about the trike. The three interesting things the Triceratops does is, first of all, as I say, this little thing over here with the herd mechanic, which is down here at the bottom. I'll show you that in a little bit. There's also an attack, so you can either left click to eat, like so, or if you hold down the button instead, yeah, she kind of like dips her head down, and then when you release it, she does like a charge. Ram, stabby stabby sort of thing. Now, that's all well and good. You can sprint forward, head down, and then, and you know, impale an enemy dinosaur. However, and this is the slightly weird thing, if you press right click instead, you get this. Yum. You get this bizarre slow motion, by the way. This is slow motion. Zoomed in kind of, it's like a bull or something. So if we hold left click and charge in like this, and then, there we go. Oh my god, that was a one-hit kill. Oh no! Oh no, Edmund! I just wanted to use an example, I'm so sorry. Am I that sorry? I'm not that sorry. I am the queen of this herd now. Maybe they'll let me join the herd. If I kill... Well, let's just try that again. Well, that's really strong, isn't it? And the Edmontosaurus can't do a bloody thing about it. It must be said. I'm just a little sad I lost the footage, because it would have been really nice to show you guys, like, all the stages of the growth. Now, it's worth saying, like I said, this is not the year public release, so it's going to be more... Sorry, I'm addicted to it now. Oh, what's this? That's Pakistan. Oh, okay, we'll kill that as well. Just kill everything, basically. Okay, let's get some food, eh? Look, there's not much else for me to do. I'm gonna kill some herbivores. Anyways, so at some point the trike will be in the public release. When that happens, I'll come back again and I'll try to record as much of the actual, you know, the growth stages as I can. But as I say, I'll show you the babby before the end of today anyway. What I was mainly hoping and trying to do in my 3 hour long journey, it's been a long day. What I was mainly trying to do was find a Tyrannosaurus Rex, especially now that I think we're old enough. I mean, we're not even an adult yet, but we could maybe compete. Oh, this is salt water. Oh no. I need moisture. Folks, I need good moisture. This is bad. I'm not this salty. Actually, I think this is you can see the colour change around here, right? Yeah, here we go. Fresh. I'm not a salty girl. I don't think I've ever said those words before. I'm not a salty girl. Apparently, I am though, because this isn't... Wait, I'm even not drinking. No, I am. I think this is still salt water. Oh, it is. You can see the colour there. I'm trapped. Oh no, this little salty pool is going to be the death of me. Hello guys, these are Ornithomimids. Not heard of those. Now, if you've never seen this game before, I wouldn't blame you if you're newish to the channel. I had a little look at my Saurian playlist before I started recording this video. You want to know when the last video I did a Saurian is? And by the way, like, the last video means the last time the game had a monumental, as far as I was concerned, upgrade. Is that a double kill? Nice! Not for you guys, that's horrible for you guys, but for me that's cool. December. Which already, so December, 8 months ago. It wasn't December 2019. It was December 2018. It was nearly 2 years ago that Saurian last had a decent sized update. Honestly, like nearly 2 years ago. And that's a lot of stuff got added, admittedly. The Ornithomimids, for example. I think six creatures. There we go. I think six creatures in total got added during that update. It was a pretty great update, but it was nearly two bloody years ago. And not that much has changed since then. We've now got the playable trike. It obviously has a full life and growth cycle, which is fantastic, but man, the death cycle of this game breaks my heart sometimes. Alright, gang, how we doing? Ornitha gang. Living large? Living large. So, as I say, I really wanted to find a T-Rex. I thought, even though we're a sub-adult, not a full adult, maybe we were just about big enough to take one on, you know? And I didn't see one in 3 hours. So I also didn't see an Ankylosaurus or anything like that, so... You know, the dinosaurs aren't that common at the end of the day. I'm gonna wander around for a little bit now, just a little bit, to see if I can find one. But if not, we're going to come back when the game hits stable release, when Triceratops hits stable release. I'll show you the entire life cycle of the Triceratops then, in a slightly less buggy version. Although it's nicer now. I was having a really weird issue with the audio, with the music before, but it seems pretty okay now. But when it's publicly out there properly, we'll do another video, I'm sure. But until then, I'm not going to spend too long looking for the Rex, I'm not going to lie. I'll spend a little bit of time if we don't find it. Ooh, what was that? You hear that? We'll hop back over to baby mode. Hello, little guy. I don't know if you can see him there, it's quite hard to spot. A little rodent. Crush. Kill. Destroy. Oh no, I did. I crushed, killed, destroyed. There's another one over there. Now, I did hear something in the distance. I'm going to go have a little peek. Oh, music's gone creepy. I will say, in Saurians, not in defense, but just as a positive for the game, it has some brilliant nighttime music. It becomes like a horror game for some reason. It's really cool. I heard something. I'm going to do a threat. Just warning them. I've got horns. I'm not afraid to use them. Super quickly. Fire on a leaf. Suck it down, basically. That sums it up. Not much else to it other than that. There's a Quetzalcoatlus over there in the sky. There you go. Eating. in case some of you haven't learned how to eat yet. It can be complicated. Tubes are very helpful if you choose to go that direction. I think I just spotted the Dakota Raptor. Now, it's not quite a Tyrannosaurus Rex, but it is a carnivore. So, we're going to right-click, and we're going in. I will say, this is pretty cool as well. It feels like I'm the bull in, like, a dramatic bull run in a film or something. Did I miss? I think I missed. Pivot! There we go. Dakota Raptor really isn't much of a match for a fully grown Triceratops, surprisingly enough. So one day we'll hop back on, take down a T-Rex, I'm sure. But I have been looking around this map for, in total now, about 3.5 hours, and I have still not seen a single Tyrannosaurus Rex. I've only seen 2 bloody Dakota Raptors. Most of the dinosaurs I see, I just see all of the Thermimids all over the bloody place, honestly. But alas, there she is. What an absolute beauty. She does look great, I will say this much. The trike looks great, feels great, it handles great. And that's not even the full release yet, so things can only get even better. There she goes. Beautiful. Oh. Yeah, she looks great. I will say that much. She looks fantastic. So, it's baby time. So, we're going to start a new game. As you can see, here is our Triceratops on the right, and that's the male. Again, as you can see, it's got a lot brighter colours and much more interesting in the patterning. So, we'll go male this time. Male this time has a lovely name, I think you'll all agree. Can I change? Does the day length, out of curiosity, affect how quickly you grow up? Because if so, that's much more exciting. we're just going to play on casual, because this is really just to try some stuff out. I just really want to show you, the herd mechanic is the coolest thing added in this update for me. Assuming it is added in this update, but I have to assume it was, because it wouldn't really make sense to be in the game before this. Here we are, our newborn baby Triceratops. Looking, as baby Triceratopses do, like a small, demonic monster of some description. They are absolutely terrifying. Look at them. Horrifying. Horrifying. I hate them. I really do. We start with the nest here, as you can see. There's a whole new tutorial system in the top left. It's a little bit small and they've picked like a really obnoxious font, so it's hard to read to an extent, but you can just about do it as long as you're willing to get a little closer to your screen. So there's Papa. There it pops. There's Mama. And there's Mama too. And there's... well, that's it, actually, in this case. There's Bro, or our sis. Oh, no. Oh, be careful. I've been crushed many times by Papa. It doesn't seem to affect our family, but... Papa has killed me several times. Haven't you, Papa? Yes, you have. Cheeky little blighter. There's Papa looking regal, I think is the word. Regal. Looks brilliant, actually. Okay, so I want to show you this herd mechanic. So when you spawn in as a baby Triceratops, you are automatically put into a herd with your clanmates, with your siblings, is the normal human term for them. And if we hit F and then we go down to the bottom here, I realise there's actually a compass as well when you hit F. Look. Heading, that's north over there. Anyways, hit F, go down to here. Oh my god, I've got so many of them. What's going on? So these are all the others, all my siblings. There's Canis, Akita, Tecmessa, Kynthia, Clytemnestra, there we go. Iris, Procris, Nikolaus. Nikolaus is an amazing name. And what we can do with these is click this little button here. Ah, Papa's Nikolaus. Oh, Papa's actually part of the clan. But basically, you can look directly at your clanmates, and they highlight them, your herdmate, as they're called. So this over here is Tecmessa, and you can see her flashing there in the middle of the screen. Tecmessa is flashing all of us. Now, you can do a couple of things here. We can rename Tecmessa to Flasher, I guess. And they've got a reputation bar. Now, I don't really know what this is all about. Tech Flasher has a 49% reputation. I have no idea what that means. In the clan? As just a famous world-touring Triceratops? Reputation seems like a really weird word to use in this context, but I just don't know what it is, so that's probably why. And you can also check on their injury, their hunger levels, their thirst levels, and their stamina. And these exclamation points will start to flash, or they'll light up in different colours, when these stats are really low. So you can kind of keep an eye on your herd mates and see if they need any help, if they need any food, if they need healing or whatever. Obviously you can't cast a spell on them to heal them, but you know, maybe you can sit down and relax and wait for them. Stuff like that. It's a pretty cool little system, must be said. Last time when I was playing with my little trike that you just saw, oh, there's more bebbers. Last time I was playing the trike you just saw, I went off with these two siblings right at the start. You know, when we were a little bit older, a little bit big enough, we left our parents behind, we formed our own little three triceratops clan, went off into the herd, I should say, it's not a clan, went off into the wilds and kind of did our own thing. It was pretty cool for a while, and then I got bored and left them, but they do seem to follow you a little bit. I don't quite know how the herd mechanics work, but I definitely got the impression, oh, mama, no! I definitely got the impression they were able to follow me around to some extent. And they definitely stuck together as well. So there is actual proper AI herding in the game. And if you want to be, you can be part of it, which is really cool, actually. It must be said. They will hang around here at the birth site for a long time before starting to migrate. I assume the idea behind that is to replicate them looking after the eggs initially. I don't know what that period would be for Triceratops, how long would a Triceratops nurture a baby trike, but I imagine if we were left like this, we'd be dead. We'd be dead pretty bloody soon, so my little demon body. Not the first time I've heard those words. Mama! They are terrifying. I don't dispute that it might well be accurate, but it is terrifying. Oh, God. Eh, that's my horn attack. Isn't it adorable? Eh! Alright, anyway, so that's basically how the Triceratops works. You walk around with your herd mates, you eat, you drink, and you very, very, very slowly grow bigger. Can't tell if that's quicker than usual. I have no idea, in all honesty. Anyways, so, as I say, this will hit stable release at some point. I would like to battle with a T-Rex. That really is my main goal for the Triceratops. You know, we've explored all around this world already, blah, 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 blah. I don't think there's much, if anything, in the way of new ambient creatures. There is a turtle that I saw. The turtle's pretty cool. But other than that, not really. Yeah, so, Saurian. We'll be back again in like a year and a half, I suppose. No, we'll definitely be back. Oh, no, they're leaving me. We'll definitely be back a little bit sooner. When you start to get too far away from your herdmates, the game will also warn you about that. They're moving much earlier than last time. I was here for about half an hour last time before there was any movement. What was I saying? Yeah, I'm sure we'll be back soon. Maybe when the trike hits stable release, maybe when I manage to find a T-Rex, just something. But I'm sure it won't be a year and a half until we come back again. After that video, maybe it will be a year and a half. Sorry, it's a weird experience. In one hand, I really appreciate it. It is possibly, in my lifetime, genuinely, the best recreation I'll ever experience of Hell Creek. It literally might be the best one I ever experience. On the other hand, it's been a year and a half since the last bloody update, so, you know, it's hard to kind of know what to do, but, ah, one, two, three, four, five, there's six of us. Got a little party going on here. A gang. How are you doing? Have a little swims. It's cute, it really is. You feel like you're part of a family unit, which you never really got with the Dakota Raptor, so it's pretty cool. Definitely give it a go. Like I said, I'm going to link in the description down below a little guide that the Saurian devs themselves have posted on how to connect to the Saurian pre-alpha beta thingamajiggy. I wonder what happens if I try to kill my parent. Let's find out. Let's finish in style. Charging in. I'm charging in! Eh. I don't think she notices. I think she literally doesn't. Mama? She doesn't care, does she? Perish, Mama! Perish! And Mama doesn't care. Mama does not wish to perish. Mama's just trying to sit on me. Right, thank you so much for joining me. I'm sorry this isn't a little bit more. Usually with Saurian, I'd record for a long time and cut it down, but I already did that. I can't do it again. We'll definitely be back again in the near future, though, so stick around for more Saurian and, of course, lots more, you know, dinosaurs, and all that kind of jazz. Thank you for joining me. Check out the guide in the description down below. Cheers, most of us, as always. Bye-bye.